puberty is awkward enough for teenagers, but now puberty is starting to occur in children as young as first grade. What is happening here, and what should we do about it? Hey there, girls and boys, Trace here for DNews. In the mid-19th century, puberty didn't start until the later teen years. By the mid-20th century, it was preteen, and today the National Institutes of Health says it starts between the ages of 8 and 13 for girls and 9 and 14 for boys. But, and I do not say this too often, those numbers aren't really accurate. Research is showing puberty can start for African-American girls as early as 6. Those girls are in first grade. We all learn puberty starts at different times for different individuals, but when it starts super early, like before age 7 or 8 for girls and before 9 for boys, it's called precocious puberty. This has happened throughout history, but usually due to glandular disorders or a tumor pressing on the pituitary gland. Some scientists believe precocious puberty is actually getting more common. The age of menarche, or first menstruation, has gotten younger by 4 months every decade for every social, economic, ethnic, and racial group from the mid-1800s until the 1960s, and doctors aren't sure why. Theories propose it could be improved health, nutrition, obesity, or even environmental factors like plastic chemicals, smoking, family structure. Studies have even found emotional stress, like when a girl has a depressed father, or a child is adopted into a foreign country, or a child is exposed to war, can all cause early onset puberty. So many things. I mean, to be honest, no one really knows why this happens. We just know it is happening for both boys and girls. We have a video explaining some of the theories if you want to know more, but today we wanted to know why it matters. It turns out that puberty, and precocious puberty, can cause some pretty serious side effects, because puberty is not just one thing. Instead, it's a whole series of changes to the body over time. Puberty is our biology, setting us up for sexual maturity, offspring creation, and adulthood. So if it starts earlier, that will affect the rest of the kid's life. For example, our bones have growth plates. During puberty, kids get a growth spurt. But if that spurt starts earlier, like at age 6 instead of a few years later, the bones will grow and then stop, causing the person to be shorter. That's right, early puberty causes short stature. On top of that, the earlier onset can change how the child sees their chronological peers, as they may more closely identify with biological peers who may be older. This loss of childhood, as it was referred to in some of the research I read, can cause children to become more sexually active at a younger age, abuse alcohol or tobacco, have lower academic achievement and delinquency, and put the kids at a higher risk for developing depression. On top of that, they could develop eating disorders, because puberty often causes weight gain, and puberty literally has been shown to make girls more cognizant of the relationship between diet, exercise, and weight. There are even more serious risks, like adult-onset asthma, type 2 diabetes, and breast cancer. Even though no one really knows entirely why this trend is happening, it's important to note, physically maturing does not mean a child is prepared for adulthood mentally. Yes, the brain is changing during puberty as well as the body, but the rational part of the brain, it doesn't stop developing until age 25. People are people, and we can't always control our biology, but we can control our social reactions to it. So keeping open and honest communication will go a long way to helping young adults adjust. It is the new normal. It's nothing to be ashamed of, and increasing awareness and acceptance while scientists do more research on why it's happening will help everyone understand it better. We hope. Knowing yourself and your body can be incredibly empowering. TLC has this show called I Am Jazz about a transgender teen who has a whole different picture of the regular drama of going through adolescence. You can watch it now by downloading TLC Go. The app will let you watch all the episodes of that and a bunch of other TLC shows right on your phone or tablet. Check out the app with the link in the description. And if you want to know a bit more about why all this early puberty stuff might be happening, check out this video. Other experts weighed in, claiming obesity was unlikely to be the only cause, and that where girls live and how much meat and dairy they have in their diet will also affect puberty onset. Even family stress has changed pubertal timing. Do you remember going through puberty? What was the worst part for you? I kept getting like giant zits right on my nose. It was the worst. Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.